good morning to all my dear children. How are you? I hope all you are doing well, right? So, last class, what are the things we need study? We studied about machines and what are the two types of machine? Manual machines and automatic machines. Then can you give some examples of manual machine? Yes, juicer machine, bicycle, that are the examples of manual machine. Why? Because it needs physical effort or it needs manual effort. And another type of machine is automatic machine. Can that type of machine need manual effort? No. Automatic machine does work automatically, right? So it does not need any human effort. Then can you give some examples of automatic machine? Yes, scooter is an automatic machine. Washing machine is an automatic machine. Then automatic juicer. So these are the examples of automatic machine. Then after that, we learn about calculator. So what is the use of a calculator? Calculator do the operations. Operation means perform operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay. Then after that, we discussed about how to operate a calculator. Okay. I hope you studied well. Now, we are going to do some exercises in this chapter. Okay, let's do it. And first one, worksheet one. Here are some pictures. Can you see these pictures? Okay, so there are two classifications in these pictures. Letter A for automatic machine and M for manual machine. So here are some of the pictures and you have to select which of the machines are under automatic and which of the machines are under manual machine. Okay, so our first picture is computer. Is a computer an automatic or a manual machine? Automatic machine, right? So for automatic machine, put a or write a letter A to this box. Write a letter A to the box. A means automatic. Okay. Then another picture is scooter. So a scooter, is it is automatic or manual? Scooter. Yes, we know scooter is an example of automatic machine. So it is automatic. So we can write letter A to this box. Okay. Next one is, what is this picture? Have you heard about abacus? Abacus means it is the first calculating device. So it does four operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc. or count. Right? So can this type of machine need any human effort? Yes, because by moving these words, we can calculate or count the numbers. So it needs a manual effort. That's why it is a manual machine. So here is a manual machine. So we write letter M to this box. So from these three pictures, first two are automatic machines and third one is manual machine. Okay. And fourth one is a juicer. We already mentioned this type of juicers in previous classes. So can you remember it? This is a juicer machine and it needs manual effort. So it is under the category of manual machine. So which letter do we write in this box? Letter M. Okay. So next one is automatic machine, automatic juicer. So the name itself, it is automatic. So we can write letter A to this box. That means it is automatic. And finally, the last picture is a bicycle. So is bicycle an automatic or manual? Bicycle is manual because it needs to be padded. That's why it is manual machine. So we can write letter M to this box. Okay. Okay. So then next is worksheet number 2. In this worksheet number, in this exercise, there is a boy. Can you see this boy? Here is a boy. His name is Mitesh. What was his name? Mitesh. So Mitesh has to go far away to a different city to see his friend. So he wants to meet her, his friend. So he wants to meet his friend, and the friend which is far away from his home. So there are three pictures. First one, Mitesh is walking alone, and another one, Mitesh on a cycle, and third picture, Mitesh on a scooter. So first picture, he walks alone, and second picture, he rides a bicycle, and third picture, he rides a scooter. Then which method should he prefer for traveling? Which is the best method? Walking or riding bicycle or ride scooter? Which one? Can you see that? Oh yes, he rides on a scooter. That's the best method because he does not tired and it needs any human effort, and also it can cover long distance. Okay, so he should prefer scooter. Here are some pictures. Can you see these pictures? The pictures of calculator, camera, a table, a computer, and a scooter. So you have to do circle around the things which is used for more than one purpose. So you have to circle among these pictures which is used for more than one purpose. Okay. So first one is calculator. So first picture is calculator, right? So we know calculator is used for calculations. It only perform calculations. So can it use any other uses? Can we use the calculator for any other purposes? No, it only used for calculating purposes. Okay, so we cannot circle the calculator. And second one is camera. Can you say that camera is a multi-purpose? No, camera is only used for recording pictures. Okay, so we cannot circle this camera. And third one, a table. So can you say a table a multi-purpose or not? Yes, table is a multi-purpose. Why? Because we can read books on the table, we can eat food on the table, we can play games on the table. So that's why table can be considered as a multi-purpose. So we can circle around this picture. Okay. And another one is computer. So is a computer a multi-purpose? Yes, we know, we already studied computer is a multi-purpose machine. Why? Computer has do many things. What are the things? We can listen music from computer, we can watch movies in the computer, we can draw pictures in the computer, we can play games in the computer. So many uses. So computer is a multi-purpose machine. So we can circle around this picture. And another one, last picture is scooter. So is scooter is a multi-purpose or not? We know scooter is only used for we can travel along for long distance, but it cannot used for any other purposes. So we cannot circle around this picture. Okay, so what are the things among these pictures which are used for more than one purpose? table and computer. Then next is worksheet number 4. So can you say me what is the use of a calculator? On a calculator you can do dash. What are the things we can do? We can do calculations. Which are the calculations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay, then another one, on a computer you can do dash. What are the things we can do in the computer? Oh, we can listen music, we can watch movies, we can play games, we can draw pictures, we can send messages, etc. So many uses. So you have to write these type of uses in these lines. Okay? Okay. Then next worksheet is, this is a calculator, right? And there are some missing numbers in this calculator. So can you help me to write that missing numbers? Here 5, 6, 9 are the numbers present. So what are the other numbers? 1 is missing. So we could write 1. Then 2. Then 3. Next 4. Then 5 here, 6 here. Any other numbers? 7, 8. Very good. Right? So this is a calculator and we can calculate all the operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and also any other calculations. Okay? Then another worksheet is, Isha has written some sentences. Help ma'am to check which are wrong and which are correct. Tick the sentence which you think that is correct or and cross the wrong sentence. Okay. The first question, machines make work difficult for a person. Is machine difficult for a person? Means, is the machine difficult for our humans? No, because machines are used for humans. Machines are used to do our work very easy. And machines are invented for humans. So is it difficult? No. So put cross mark to this box. Okay. It is false. That means it is wrong answer. And second one, in an automatic machine, you do not need to put any physical effort. In an automatic machine, you do not need any effort to that machine. Is that right or wrong? Yes, is that right? Because we know in automatic machine, it does not need any physical effort. We do not need to put any effort to that machine because it automatically works. So the answer is correct. And we put a tick mark on this box. Okay. Then third one, in a manual machine, you do not need to use physical effort. In a manual machine, you do not need any effort to that machine. Is that correct or wrong? In a manual machine, do we have to put any effort? Yes, because we have to need effort, like we have to put something effort to that machine because it manually works. So this question is wrong. So we put cross mark onto this box. Then fourth question, you can make drawings using a calculator. So we already discussed about calculator. Calculator is used for calculating numbers or calculating operations. So here the question is, you can make drawings using a calculator. Is a calculator can make a draw? Is this right or wrong? Wrong. So put a cross mark to this box. And fifth question, on a computer you can type letters. Yes, we can type letters through keyboard. We can type letters through keyboard. So the question is correct and we put tick mark onto this box. And next question, you need to have two computers if you want to draw pictures and type letters. Do we need two computers? Yes? No. We can type letters or draw pictures in a single computer. So we do not need more than one computer. So is this question right or wrong? Wrong. So put cross mark into this box. Then seventh question, automatic machines are faster than manual machine. Is this right or wrong? Automatic machines faster or slow? Yes, automatic machines are faster than manual machines. So we can put a tick mark onto this box. Okay, then eighth question, computers can work without instructions. Can this question correct or not? Is this correct or not? It's not, because computers works with the, or computers works according to the instruction we given to the computer. It works on the basis of instruction. So this question is wrong. So put a cross mark onto this box. The ninth question, computers can work on petrol. Is this correct? No, because computers work on, we already discussed, it works on the basis of instruction. It do not have any petrol. So this question is wrong, so that we can put a cross mark onto this box. And last question, a single computer can do many tasks. Right or wrong? Yes, a single computer can do many things like listening, watching movies or any other uses. So this is right and we can put a tick mark to this box. Okay, and this chapter is over. Which chapter? So our first chapter is over. So I hope you studied well. So the next chapter is computer parts. So what is our next chapter? Second chapter. So what is its name? Computer parts. Computer parts. We know human body have different parts. So what are the parts in the human body? Yes. Head, ear, eyes, nose, mouth, hand, leg, etc. Human body have different parts. So in our body there are different parts. Okay, I know you already know something about the human body parts. Okay, similarly computer is made up of different parts. Computer is also made up of different parts. Let's see what are the parts of a computer. Okay. Okay. There are mainly five important parts of a computer. So what are the five important parts of a computer? So what are the five parts? First one, monitor. So first one is monitor. Okay. Monitor is the part of a computer, right? And second one is keyboard. So what is the second part? Keyboard. Okay. And third part is CPU. So what is our third part? CPU. And fourth part is mouse. Fourth part is mouse. And fifth part is speaker. So what are the basic components of a computer? What are they? Monitor, keyboard, CPU, mouse and speaker. Okay. Have you seen computers? Have you seen these parts? Yes. You know the parts of the computer. So one by one, we we can discuss. Then first part of the computer is monitor. Can you see that? This is the first part of our computer. So what is its name? Monitor. M O N I T O R. Monitor. Then monitor has a front, has a screen in its front. So monitor is look like this. It has a screen. It has a screen in its front. Then what is the use of monitor? We can display output through this monitor. We can display output. So monitor is used to display the results. So that means display the things what we are doing in the computer. Okay, so display what you are doing on the computer. Doing on the computer. On the computer. And it has a screen in its front. Okay. So there are different monitors, LCD monitors, LED monitors, etc. Okay. And the features of LED monitors are very rich quality and it less prone to any other it does not affect our eye or vision. Okay. That monitor is different types. LED monitors are available, LCD monitors are available, and also in different ranges, 15 inch, 17 inch, 19 inch, 21 inch. Okay. Okay. And the flat screen monitors are known as LED. Flat screen monitors are known as LED. So what is LED monitors definition? Flat screen monitors. Flat screen monitors. Flat screen monitors are LED. Okay, so first important part is monitor. Monitor is used to display the output or the results or what we are doing on the computer, right? And it has a screen on its front. Then different types of monitors, and flat screen monitors are LED monitors, okay, which is rich in quality. Okay, next one is CPU. CPU, Central Processing Unit. C, Central. P, Processing. And U, Unit. Okay, so CPU means Central Processing Unit. Very good. Then it is known as brain of the computer. It is known as brain of the computer. So CPU is known as brain of computer. So CPU is known as brain of the computer because it solves all the computations or all the problems given by the computer. So why we call the CPU is the brain of the computer? Because it solves all the problems given by the computer. So what is the full form of CPU? Central Processing Unit. And it is known as brain of the computer because it solves all the problems given by the computer. Okay. Then Next one is and this is CPU. Right? Okay. And third part is keyboard. So which is our third part? Keyboard. Keyboard means it has many keys. This is an input device and it has many keys. Key means arrangement of rectangular buttons. Key means arrangement of rectangular buttons called keys. And this key contains alphabets, numerics, signs. And the key contains what are the things? Alphabets, numbers, alphabet. Numbers and numbers and signs. So keyboard has many keys. It is the rectangular arrangement of buttons called keys and it contains alphabets, numbers and signs. What are alphabets? Alphabet means A, B, C, D, right? Alphabet. Alphabets means A, B, C, D, E, F, G, etc. up to Z. Then numbers means one, two, three, etc. And signs means plus sign, minus sign, star, comma, exclamatory mark, dollar symbol, etc. So what are the things a keyboard contain? It contain alphabets, numbers, signs. Then we can give instruction to this keyboard. We can give instruction or commands to this keyboard. Okay, so the third part is keyboard. Keyboard contains many keys. Key means arrangement of rectangular buttons. Okay. And what are the things that keyboard contains? Alphabets, numbers and signs. Alphabet means A, B, C, D, letters. Numbers means 1, 2, 3 digits. And third one, signs means plus sign, minus sign, into, star, division or exclamatory mark, question mark, equal to sign, etc. Okay. And here is the keyboard. Here is the keyboard, okay? Then, next one is mouse. Mouse is also an input device. We can give commands to this mouse. And it is a pointing device. Pointing device means it has a pointer like this. It has a pointer. Mouse is a pointing device. Okay. Then in mouse is like, it is looks like a mouse. Right? And in mouse, it has two buttons and there is a scroll in between two buttons. So mouse has how many buttons? A left button, a right button, and there is a scrolling wheel in between two buttons. So input device mouse, and we can give commands through mouse. So how many buttons in a mouse? Left button, right button, and there is a scrolling wheel in between them. So we can point a thing in the computer using this mouse. So first class is over and then we continue in another class. Thank you. Have a nice day.